So in terms of me going viral, that was not planned out. I didn't put out that tweet thinking, okay, this is going to be the piece of content that millions of people see and that people are going to now know me for, right? I didn't set out to be like, okay, I want people to know me as the British female deadlift champion. Like, that's what people are.
That's what people, you know, like.
Okay, I'm going to say it. Fucking genius.
Of all the things I could be known for in the world, that wasn't really sort of what I planned out.
Kills me.
But what happened is that, you know, that did happen. And what was great is because I've done so much work in the past, over the past decade plus, through my music, through everything else that I do, a lot of people discovered me through that, but then they were like, oh, okay, there's a lot more to this person than just this. Oh, he raps. Oh, he's got a podcast. Oh, he's quite interesting. He's funny, whatever. So that's really what led to the growth in the following and the audience. So in terms of me going to the States, I actually had, so I'd been invited to do the Rubin Report and the Joe Rogan podcast. And then once I sort of had those two in the bag and I knew I was going to the States, more dominoes just started falling. So I was just like, look.
Because you'd already got the kudos of those two.
Yeah. Yeah. And I was telling people, you know, like I went to LA first. So it's like, look, I'm in LA for 2 weeks. I've never been here before. If you want to talk to me, if you've got a podcast, a YouTube channel, whatever, you want to interview me, you just want to hang out, let's do it. I did the same thing in San Francisco, in Dallas, in Atlanta, and you know, every city that I went to.
Amazing.
And
yeah, amazing.
More and more opportunities just kept coming. And yeah, I mean, it was an incredible trip. It was a truly, truly incredible trip. There was so much love. And it's interesting
crazy,
because
crazy watching it. It was
yeah.
Crazy watching it.
Yeah. Yeah, so and it, thank you, bro. Thank you. And you know, it really felt good because we live in a very online world, probably now more than ever before with this social distancing thing. And yeah, the thing about online is you can see the numbers and you can see statistics and analytics and stuff. You can see how many people download this podcast, how many people listen on YouTube, et cetera. But as you know, you're a performer, you do live performances, and there's a difference between seeing numbers rack up on a YouTube channel and being in front of people and yeah, actually receiving that love. You do a gig and people are coming up to you after. It's, yo, man, like what you did is so sick. I love this. Someone stopping you in the street, whatever. That's just a yeah, whole different feeling than a sort of cold, hard number, which doesn't yeah, really mean anything to you. Like you can sort of fathom it, but you also really don't.